Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, this is day three talking about this data set where we have date and time in column A. Now, here's another gotcha that you can watch out for. Yesterday, we used the INT function in column B to separate the date portion from the date and the time. Well, in this case, I get a value error. And let's hold down the control key and press the backwards accent. In the US, that's on the same key as the tilde right underneath the F1. And we'll see show formulas mode, and we'll see over there in column A, that's just text. It's not really a date and time that's stored over there. Now, we'll contrast that to yesterday's data set. If I would do the same thing with yesterday's data set, we actually have serial numbers stored over there. It's a real date and time. So, in this case, we have a couple of problems. Well, the one thing we could do is just look at that and say, okay, the year, the month, the day, plus two periods is taking up 10 characters. So, we could ask for equal left of this, comma 10, and that will give us just the date portion. Unfortunately, it's still giving us just a text representation of the day. Well, this is going to be a little bit more difficult because now when we put in 9/1/2006 and we copy that down, we're going to have to add an intermediate formula over in column G that says equal text of that date using a format of yyyy.mm.dd. And that will take the real date in column F and convert it to a text date in column G. Copy that down. And now it's a matter of using the same formula we used yesterday, equals SUMIF. Take a look at all those dates in column B. See if they're equal to this text date in column G. And if it is, add up the corresponding cell from column C. Copy that down. Now, a completely different approach, if we didn't want to have to have this extra column G, is to write probably a more difficult formula back in column B. This is using the date function, equal date, and we need to pass it a year, a month, and a day. Well, for the year, that's the leftmost four characters of cell A2. For the month, we'll use mid and ask for the sixth for a length of 2. And then for the day, we'll use mid again, this time asking for the ninth character for a length of 2. That will convert that text date over in column A to a true date. Now, when we format this, we'll choose in the date, maybe the first date format. Copy that down to all of our cells. I'll double click the fill handle. And now we don't have to use this intermediate column G. We can actually have this based on column F. So, what started out a few days ago with a very, very simple question, hey, how do I summarize this data by date? There were a lot of landmines that caused some problems. More than 32,000 rows, so we couldn't do a pivot table in Excel 2003. Yesterday, we took a look at a simple formula that will be very easy if the data in column A truly is a serial number, date and time. But today, if we have text over there, and it's hard to tell unless you press Show formulas, that's control and the grav accent, to tell whether you have text or a date. In this case, we had to jump through some hoops to convert those text dates to real dates. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.